affecting myself today. I'm going to go and have my guests whom I'm going to give the opportunity to introduce themselves. And just before that, remember to send in your feedback to your semester 2242 and follow me on my social media platforms, topics underscore S. Welcome.
Hey, I'm having a question. I am facing the effort. I'm trying to do
it. I'm a year from now to the first of that name, psychiatrist, or university college of self science.
Let's to begin our discussion. We can begin by looking at social media being a source of depression to the current society.
Social media is a very big platform that shows the youth some of the things that some of them find several things that they underwent. Then the social media, they need these issues and they try to do them and see what they do. And from that point, for them to find the special programs, they are forcing them some financial pressures, making some of them creation. And most of the youths, their life starts losing control. So social media is a very vital messing up the life of the youth, giving the services and the programs to watch.
This guy is not a person of pressure.
having sight of children with this thing, now they're separated, having lost everything. Now he was alone, then the wife was alone with the children. Now the only thing they have to stand right now, one of the daughters was supposed to celebrate her birthday party, and the wife requested the husband to come over so they can celebrate together. But the husband, being that who was still in that state of depression, what he had gone through, told the wife that being that the children might take me for strength when I attend the party, maybe let them come over so that you stay, so that you become familiar, so that when the party comes, I won't be staying again. But it's from there that we are finding out that the mother and the kids came to the mother. For which sources say that this the three seems to be probably mother. I'm saying all this because everything starts from where this broke up. And you know, breakups come with depression. After those emotions and feelings.
This is somebody who, from the onset of the relationship, the family itself rejected her spouse. So from that point, he's been living without that feeling of rejection. And that, I can say, is when the depression began. And it has built up over time, and at the end, it has been up. So,
we saw it in the news, it was there. And they seem to be so caring to him, and they defended him, saying that he's just a cold person, he even can't start up life. So, is there pretense?
Yeah, they try to hide, you know, those feelings. He has built them up over time, but you know, if you could see him, he could be an ordinary guy, but deep inside, he maybe have that feeling of rejection. So, you know, people can hide. The mind is very complex in how it works.
Yeah. Also, I have to say, being a parent, I have to hide the bad side of my kid. I can't come and tell them that, you know, Esther, my child, that reason is. No, as a parent, I have to play the good role. So to you, I'll come and tell you all the good side of my kid, but there are some things that they're bad. I have to hide them. So maybe this guy was suffering from depression and the man knows, but she cannot tell the public that, yes, my son was suffering from depression that led him to murder the family.
A friend of Mugore, also whose name remained with her, said that he was also aware that his friend was undergoing depression, because he mentioned that there's this time it used to rain and he would go stand in the rain for almost an hour. So we as the society, then we are also ignorant of cases of depression. We don't act to them until it is too late.
Also, I was trying to give an account of whatever he has experienced, being that he was a close guy to the so-called Mugore. And he was aware of the experiences that he had gone through during the life of being rejected, during the life of family, interracial marriage affairs, and pushing him out of the marriage. He was aware this person was depressed.
Our society puts unrealistic, you know, expectations on men. Like, you're not supposed to display your emotions, you're not supposed to go look for help, you know, like job. So, you know, that's also one of the things that, you know, give people such a worry that, you know, our society is very, let's say it's very biased.
So, moving on to our other topic of discussion, it's trying to analyze. We all heard of the late Tycoon Toby's wife, Sarah Wairimu, and a stereotype, or I'd rather say stereotypes, erupt based on issues that are taking place in our current generation. For instance, in this case, the Kikuyu ladies were stereotyped into whereby opinions were you shouldn't marry a Kikuyu lady because they are just after your money, and once they get it, they kill you. What do you think?
Like Sarah was just married to the Cohen innocently, like normal people. And we are told that they lived for several years and had two children. But now, every person has feelings and every person has emotions. Now it comes a time the Cohen is about to leave and go back to their country. And everything that they are working to build with Sarah is winning to his sisters and brothers back to their family, leaving Sarah with totally nothing at hand, having spent a very long time of her life with this guy. So it was expected that even though the wing was to be, some part of the wing was to go to the family members, but Sarah was supposed to be given a portion. And that you can confirm, it's true that any normal woman would have done that. After you live several years with a guy and you have made too much wealth and now everything is being given to a sister, but a sister back somewhere. And you are being left with the kids, and this will keep you ladies being gold diggers. I think it's not fair, and anybody can marry, anybody can kill. So, according to me, stereotyping people, ladies, being murdered as well, being gold diggers, no.
You can take some away from what I say, something about stereotyping. I would say, most of the stereotypes are based on facts. So, what you maybe in Sarah's case, to get into the, you know, the specifics of it, maybe the stereotypes are based on facts. Maybe keeping in mind that entrepreneurial, there are opportunities, I would say that. Because of what happened, I think, just as a balance, any human being, having that feeling of being left behind, as you know, the little baby had it, you know, indicated if you will get some of the estates, she had to, you know, retaliate, and maybe that is a little bit.
Do you suppose that stereotypes have been a source of spreading tribalism in our country today? I think for those who contributed your feedback, I've seen them, they've been coming. Join me next in my other show. I've been your host.